cut off this and that.
I don't know.
Oh, there.
Everybody
want
to take their seats?
Hey,
what's going on?
I haven't been to
the
Excellent. Hey, good seeing you.
My wife is ready. She wants us to get started. See you later, right there. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the huge celebration that we're going to be having tonight for the 2016 PIAA Boys State Volleyball Champions. But we didn't have volleyball here at the Hempfield that time. But anyway, then we started playing rec ball together about the late 70s and 80s against one another, and this team always beat ours. So we kind of drifted apart, and then when my son started playing in 97, we became friends again. So that's how I know Mike, and I think probably other than some of his players from the 91 team, I've known him the longest, and that's why I was selected to do this job. Mike's coaching career started in 91 as an assistant coach with Ryan Strait, who was the head coach. And during that time, from 91 till 97, he was assistant coach and they won three state championships, 94, 96, and 97. During that time, or during his 27 years, including last year, during his 27 years, he's won many, many section titles. He's won 22 league championships. He's won 13 district championships and 10 state championships. Not to mention, he was also head volleyball girls coach. And from 93 till 2008, I believe, 28, he has won many league, district, and two state championships with the girls. know, if you gathered all that gold medal that he has, if it was real gold medal, he would probably be great friends with President Donald Trump. But it's not quite real. He has also been elected to the PA Sports Hall of Fame and also the PA Volleyball Coaches Association Hall of Fame. I probably missed some, but you just have to forgive me on that, Mike, because I am getting older, you know. But I don't know, maybe you're older than I am. That doesn't matter. I'm sure Coach Vogel doesn't look at those titles and all those winnings as his most accomplishments. His most accomplishments have been with his players, his parents, and the fans, of course, and I think we all can attest to that. He looks for his players to play at their top level. He's hard on them at practice. He tries to get the best out of them, and they need to realize that, and I think most of them do. He wants them to succeed on the court and also in the classroom, in the academics. And a lot of these players go on to play at college and collegiate levels, and a lot of them have succeeded at national championship titles. Matter of fact, today we have a few of those people with us, and at this time I would like to introduce the other nine state championship teams. So when I call your name, would you please rise, and we'll give these folks a round of applause after all of them have been called per year. So in the 1994 year, we have Chad Dehoff. Please stand. These guys are losing their hair already. Grant Showdown. And Tim Clark. The 1994. Drew Dillon and Ryan Hayes. behalf of the Hempfield Volleyball Parents Alumni Association, I'd like to thank all of you for coming tonight. I'd like to thank Mike Bogle for quite a run, and we're not done. We need a couple more of those up there. Then let's do it.
Wendy O'Wall.
One more time for all the past state champions. I have the pleasure of introducing the 2016 state championship team. Benny Crabtree. Benny, you're tonight. There he is. Elvin Lupin. Thank you. may want to get your pictures ready if you want to hop over there quickly. Okay, guys. Fans, can you help me count this down? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lots of folks are at the Parkland game. And after talking to the coach, it was a combination, I think, of three things that really got us over the hump and propelled us to the state championship. And that was the coaches, certainly the players, but really it was about all of you fans. And I have a little story to tell you. So, as you all may have known, I took a lot of pictures and so forth of the students as they played throughout the years. And I'm on the bench, and the Parkland folks are right behind me. And as you know, they have a really good student section. They're really good. We got to give them credit. They're good. And how many people remember the guy with the big pizza hat? Does anybody remember that guy? Huge pizza hat. He was kind of the leader of the chant. Well, as we are going back and forth in this major tussle, I hear the student section say, "Who are all those ladies with the scarves?" And they are in the scarf ladies, right? And then near the end of the game, the pizza guy says, "But there's just one lady that will not sit down." Okay? So who do we think that is? Who might that be? Well, it was a fantastic game. We ended that game winning it in a five-set thriller. Tyler Buderball had the most unbelievable game, I think, of his career. 7 serves in a row to win that match, propelled us to the state championship. A couple of more thank yous to our police and firefighters. Are they here? Hopefully they didn't do that. Take a look. There's a picture outside. We actually had a police and a fire truck escort bring all the kids back from the 2016 state championship. Thank you, fellas. Coach Griffiths, please join me. Coach Griffiths brought some serious toughness to this team, and he is known for that, and we appreciate that. Coach Burrell. I refer to Coach Burrell translator. Because we have the two old school guys here, and Michael takes all of that and translates it into millennial talk so that all of these guys understand exactly what they need to be done. No other place did that happen last year, and we were playing Penridge, and Michael took over one of the huddles, and at a critical time, translated everything that needed to be done, and we went another 5-7 really. Last but not least, Gary Dim. So the first time I had to introduce Gary, I said, Gary, I need a few words to introduce you to the crowd. And he said, just use my name, Gary Dim, and that's it. Well, Gary's much more than that, as you know. Gary plays a critical role in finding and teaching all of us and all of our children about volleyball. He runs all of the rec programs and so forth, and Gary really is a critical part of the success of Hempfield Volleyball. So I want you to do me a big favor. I want you to give Gary and the rest of the coaches another standing ovation. Athletic Director Polonis was on a little trip. He was on a hiking trip in North Carolina, Boone, North Carolina, climbing Godfather Mountain. 5,000 feet up in the air, and who does he be at the top of the mountain other than someone carrying a Council Rock volleyball backpack? And he introduced himself and he said, hi, I'm Steve Polonis from Hempfield. And the guy says, boy, you guys are good. So again, thank you to the fans. So now what we're going to do, if everybody can take their seats, we're going to do a little movie. We put together a movie for the 2016 team. We're going to show that up here. We're going to cut the lights, have a little fun.
That's pretty cool. That's the way it's going to be always for the rest of the year, with the exception of a couple of our games in the LOV. But it's going to be tight like this all the time. Thank goodness we got a big push in the end. Hey, but you guys stay focused, you want to keep everybody out there, okay? Are you underclassmen? If you want to get back here,
we want to get back here.
Yeah, we want to get back here. Not only if you work your tail off, we get back here. It's a great feeling.
Hey, one last time, let's go! Let's go! Half out on three! One, two, three, half down!
You three seniors, that's it. You're done. Good high school volleyball.
I'm giving up for the three seniors and about a volleyball.
Thank you.
his hat. And he knew there's one gentleman I need to thank. He's not here tonight. Well, two people, actually. Michael's brother, Charles Carrill, helped me put that together, along with Ned Shear. And where's Ned? He's our good there. Thank you, Ned. Folks, that concludes the ceremony. I just want to thank you all on behalf of everybody for coming out. We're going to do two pictures here. The past champions with the 2016 team, as well as the 2016 team and coaches. So if you guys wouldn't mind hanging around, we'd really, really appreciate it. Once again, everybody, thank you. Really appreciate it.